One, two. All right. Man, you guys have popcorn and everything.
I know. It smells so good.
Yeah. Maybe later.
Maybe. Hard to sing any popcorn.
Thank you for coming.
Do you know what the weather in Montana is like today? Really not like this.
It's not like this.
We're happy to be here. We are happy to be here. Yeah.
Yeah,
it was cold.
That's where we live. Hey, nice shirt.
Yeah, wow.
Wow.
All right, you guys ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Right, let's play some music.
Special button you have to step on before you do this job.
It's kind of a thing they do in Florida, see? They plug in.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I heard that. You know, we have used to play with a guy who had a mute pedal like this. I have a tuner down here, and if you press it to tune, then it mutes everything. And And he would always, when he went to hit his boost, he would hit his mute instead, and we'd always make fun of him. But now I hope he's not watching. Okay, now that we're now that I'm unmuted, we're going to do you a song that I wrote a while ago, and I was just recently. This song was named Song of the Year by the International Western Music Association.
Yeah, all and, you Western music fans.
Yeah, and it's about a a cowboy from Scotland. Back in the Old West, before there was barbed wire, even after barbed wire, there was. Most of the cowboys were immigrants, as were most of the people that lived out west. And what Hollywood doesn't show you is that about a third of all the old cowboys were black. A lot of them were, you know, freed slaves and things like that. But this is a song about a guy from Scotland that comes over to looking for adventure and becomes a cowboy and then realizes how much it sucks. And
not what it cut out to.
Yeah, he wants to go home, but he can't because he's a cowboy. So it's called Angus McKenzie. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2. Angus McKenzie, o'er the raging Atlantic I've come. Hang your hat on a nail and I tell you my tale. I promise that I'll not keep you long. Come and listen to the words of my song. I left the shores of dear Scotland on a clipper ship bound to the west. Last of four sons, I was foolish and young. To the plains of Wyoming I pressed. Adventure was a drama of best. Now I'm spending my life chasing cattle for a man that I never have known. And all he will pay is a dollar a day. I haven't a place to call home. Days of my youth now have flown. In the dust and the heat of the summer, through the breaks and the badlands I ride. And when the winter wind blows, it cuts clear through my bones. I feel like I'm frozen inside, and I haven't a place I can hide. And at night, when I gaze at the fire, it's the highlands I've got on my mind. And alas, back at home before starting to roam, only now that I'm old do I find that I've left all I love there behind. And when I dream now, I always hear voices crying, laddie, won't you come on back home. How I long to return, but the wages I earn as a cowpuncher won't let me go. I'll die in the saddle, I know. I'll die in the saddle, I know. Thank you very much.
You want to introduce yourself?
Well, I should introduce this fella who's sitting next to me playing the mandolin. He's a fantastic mandolin player. If you haven't figured that out already, you will before the night's over. And good friend of ours who lived in Bozeman until just a few years ago, now lives in Victor, Idaho. And
home of Ben Winship.
Home of Ben Winship, who maybe watching at this very moment. But anyway, originally from St. Louis, one of my best friends. This is Tom Murphy, everybody.
Well, thank you. Thank you, John.
So this next song is a cautionary tale to all you guys. Like I'm one to be given advice.
Too late.
This is one that, it's another one that I wrote that, it's about staying out a little bit too late. Which I would never do myself, being a musician and all. It's called Mama Don't Like It When I Come Home Late. Just fooling around. Then the police came and took us all downtown. Well, the sergeant said, "Don't give you the news. You're gonna spend the night in the calaboose." I said, "You better get one thing straight. Tank's topped off, but I'm running behind. Well, I gotta get the liquor to the county line. Well, so I'm cruising along, thinking behind him in the clear. Till I see the flashing lights in the rearview mirror. In case you didn't hear, I'll reiterate. A night on the town can really be great. But mama don't like it when I come in late. Yeah, she rules the roost, there's no debate. The mama don't like it when I come in late. When I come in late.
When he comes in late.
When I come in late.
When he comes in late.
Thank you. Thanks so much. Well, speaking of Mama, I'm going to introduce you to...
That song was not about me.
No, she's very forgiving. This is my beautiful bride sitting next to me and singing, and I just am very lucky to have her as a traveling companion and a life companion. This is Joanne Gardner Lowell, everybody.
Yeah.
We're gonna have Tom sing you one here. It's kind of an obscure Bob Dylan song.
Handful of years ago, Tim O'Brien put out an album of all Bob Dylan songs, and he covered this one on there. That's where I first heard it. In fact, it was many years after that recording before I actually heard Dylan's version of this song. But
Tim was pretty faithful to it, though.
Yeah, yes, he was. This one's called Senor, Tales of Yankee Power. Like many Dylan songs, I don't know what it's really about, but it's a lot of fun to play.
Yeah,
it feels like something. Whatever it means to you, that's it.
Okay.
Oh, better fix that one first, though. You know, it's wonderful coming to the southeast, but it's been doing some funny stuff to my tuning.
Right, it's called humidity. We don't have that.
You should get a stunt guitar like mine.
Yes. We'll talk about John's getting new guitar in a minute. It's kind of a Frankenstein, but okay, senor. Ready? Senor, senor, can you tell me where we're heading? Like a county road or Armageddon? 'Cause it seems like I've been down this way before. Is there any truth in there, senor? Senor, senor, can you tell me where she's hiding? How long are we gonna be riding? How long must I keep my eyes glued to the door? Is there any comfort here, senor? Now there's a wicked wind just blowing on the upper deck, quack, hanging around her neck. Marching bands to marching in that vacant lot where she held me in her arms one time, said forget me not. Senor, senor, well, I can see the painted wagon, smell the tail of the dragon, but I can't stand the suspense here anymore. Can you tell me what when you wore, senor? Now the last thing that I remember, for I stripped and kneeled, was a trail line full of fools bogged down in a magnetic field. Gypsy with a broken flag and flashing ring sets on the scene a dream, no more it's a real thing. Senor, senor, you know their hearts are hard as leather. Give me a man, let me get it together. Gotta pick myself up off the floor, but I'll be ready when you are, senor.
Senor. Well, let's overturn these tables and disconnect these cables, 'cause I gotta pick myself up off the floor. Can you tell me what we're in for, Senor? It seems like I've been down this way before. Is there any truth in there, Senor?
That's Tom Thank Murphy, you. Everybody.
Bob Dylan song, thanks.
All right. Well, we're going to play you a song we have never played in front of anybody before.
There were those people.
Those other people.
Yeah, those other people. But it's our first public time. It's such a pretty rendition, and it's such a pretty song. And if anybody wants to dance, this would be a really good song to dance to.
You ready?
Yeah.
Just like children sleeping, we could dream this night away. But there's a full moon rising, let's go dancing in the light. Let's go out and feel alive. Because I'm still in love with you, I wanna see you dance again. Because I'm still in love with you on this farthest moon. When we were strangers, I watched you from afar. When we were lovers, I loved you with all my heart. But now it's getting late, and that moon is climbing high. I want to celebrate, see it shining in your eyes. Because I'm still in love with you, I want to see you dance again. Because I'm still in love with you on this harvest moon. Thank you. I'm still in love with you. I want to see you dance again, because I'm still in love with you. On this harvest moon,
Joanne Lowell,
thank
everybody.
Thank you.
Harvest Moon. The great Neil Young.
Yeah.
Harvest Moon.
He does a slightly different version.
We're going to do an old bluegrass song right now. Carter family song. Any really old bluegrass song that nobody really knows where it came from, they just say, oh, it's an old Carter family song, and yeah, everybody accepts that. For
and you're probably usually right. They did everything.
If they didn't write it, they just said they did. Thanks so much.
those fast ones, John.
I know. Well, this isn't one of those.
Oh,
this
well,
next one.
They'll like it.
We're going to do this one and then get our good buddy Jason up here to play with us. This is one that I wrote, I don't know, a couple of years ago. Depth of the pandemic. I'm thinking, man, here I am, a musician, and I got no gigs.
So, none of us did, John. None of us did.
I know, but I was feeling sorry for me, not you.
So this is a song for all of us, right?
That's right.
Okay.
There's a song called The Carolina Star, which is about a woman who's taking care of three kids while her husband is off in Nashville trying to become a country music star. And this is kind of the point of view from, and he's, you know, he won't give up. And this is kind of the point of view from that same guy who's there trying to make it, and he's just having a hard time. It's called I'm Going Home. City lights are burning bright. These low-down blues return tonight. My main point of concern is I have got nothing more to show in this thing they call the music game. Everything is still the same, and why I keep on playing when I'm losing, I don't know. Well, from the day I first hit town, I knew that if I would buckle down, play my songs and make the rounds, that I would have it made. But I found out the hard way fast, don't catch fish with every cast, and optimism just does not last when all your cards are played. You know it's hard to watch a dream die, no matter what the dream is, and I never thought retreat was quite my style. But it's been some time since I have known just where my self-esteem is. And there's no fruit from all the seeds I've sown. So boys, I've had enough, I'm going home. Whether busking with this old guitar, or just for tips in a roadside bar, $10 doesn't go too far when you're living in the red. I wonder if I may have stayed too long. No one wants to play my songs, and everything is just way too wrong for me to get ahead. You know it's hard to watch a dream die, no matter what the dream is, and I never thought defeat was quite my style. But it's been some time since I have known just where my self-esteem is. There's no fruit from all the seeds I've sown.
So boys, I've had enough, I'm going home. When I get back, I won't be alone. So boys, I've had enough, I'm going home.
Thank you.
So a long time ago, there used to be this band named Cane's River, and John was the lead guitar player and songwriter.
John
and
was
singer.
Very just a little guy.
Just he was young. Say, he right? was 11, yeah. And Jason was much younger as well, and he played the fiddle.
He was like 6 months.
Exactly, he was really young. But they had a wonderful run and made some records and got some festivals, and they had a really good time.
Yes,
so.
We did.
But we are in different parts of the country now. We don't get to see you, so it's good to see you.
So we're going to do one that I wrote that we recorded on a record called The Same River Twice, and you have a record right there of that. Is that your favorite song? All right. Well, Joanne's going to sing it for you. It's called Jerusalem's Choir.
For 40-some years I've been walking the line, swinging this hammer in a cold, dark mine. I'd like to say that I'm doing fine, but I'm just getting older and tired. I work down here, but I can't ever leave. Black hole, black heart, black air that I breathe. But I'll see the light on the day I'm received, and I'm singing in Jerusalem's choir.
Time's at hand, carry me home up to the promised land. I want to play in the angel band, I want to sing in Jerusalem's choir.
So I'll keep working in this deep, dark hole till the thunder rolls and the thunder rolls. Then the good Lord is gonna take my soul and I'll be singing in Jerusalem's choir.
All good promised land. I want to play in the angel band. I want to sing in Jerusalem's choir. I want to play in the angel band. I want to sing in Jerusalem's
a word. I feel bad because it was a really good word. Till the trumpet sound and the thunder rolls. Man. Good song. John wrote that song.
Nice job singing, though. Well, it's January, as you are well aware, I'm sure, and the full moon that we just got done, got through with, is called a wolf moon, and January, and February is often called the hunger moon. This is by the Native Americans, at least out west. And of course, you've heard of the harvest moon in the fall.
Sang a song about that.
And that's right, we just sang it. This is our moon set. And I found out just recently that the full moon in June is called a strawberry moon. And that sounded like a song to me, so I made one. And so it's called the strawberry moon. So Tom's going to kick it off, and it's going to go about this fast, Tom.
Charlie was walking and humming a song, enjoying the morning as he ambled along. The grass was green and the springtime air was sweet. Kate was standing alone in the square of the town. Her dress was embroidered with her long hair down. Her eyes shone bright like the stars on a moonlit night. She saw Charlie walking, she stopped and she stared. She'd heard people talking, but she never dared to believe in the thing, love at first sight. Will you take my hand on a summer night in June? Doesn't matter how long we walk, it's over too soon. Strawberry moon, strawberry moon. Well, now Kate wasn't bashful, she never had been. She walked up to Charlie while remarking to him, "You looking like a guy that a gal like me ought to know." He said, "You're probably right, so is it safe to assume you were walking with me beneath the strawberry moon when the springtime shines on the maples on the street? Will you take my hand on a summer night in June? It doesn't matter how long we walk, it's over too soon. Beneath the strawberry moon,
and walk in the moonlight on their very first date. And that's where the seed of this romance started to bloom. Now it's been 50 years since the day that they met. The love that they share, they say, is good as it gets. And the whole thing started with a stroll neath the strawberry moon. Take my hand on a summer night in June. It doesn't matter how long we walk, it's over too soon. Beneath the strawberry moon. Strawberry moon. Beneath the strawberry moon. Strawberry moon.
Should we stop or should we do another one? Okay, let's
one more.
Do one more.
Hey, once again, Jason Thomas on the fiddle. Yeah, how about that stuff? Whoa!
All right.
And thank all of you. What a cool place you have to listen to music.
Thanks to Chris for having us here. We'll do this song. It's another one that I wrote that Jason and I used to play together a long time ago. This comes from a tour that we did. We all flew to San Francisco and rented a car and drove down to Central California around San Luis Obispo and did a festival there for about 3 days. And then we climbed back in the car and played in outside of Santa Barbara, a place called Ben Lomond up in the hills. And then we did a show at the Freight and Salvage and went to the Monterey Aquarium. Remember that? That was pretty fun. Then we all loaded up on a plane and flew across the continent to Pittsburgh, and where we rented another car and drove to Gettysburg and did a festival for a couple of days and then drove back. And in Aspenwald, which is a suburb of Pittsburgh, we did another concert, and then we all went home. And so when I totaled up all the expenses and the income and everything, I was able to write a check to everybody for $100.
Yeah.
Living large.
Yeah, that's living the dream right there. But we had a good time, and the way I figured, if you're going to make $100 in 10 days, at least you should have a good time. But anyway, I got this song out of it. It's not about that particular tour, but it is about playing music on the road with your buddies, which is a lot of fun. So it's called Somewhere Down the Road, and then in the middle of it, we're going to stick an old Flat and Scruggs song that's entitled simply Down the Road, and then we're going to come back out and change keys and see if we can end on the same beat. And
see you in the lobby afterwards.
That's right. We have some CDs out there. So so here it goes. It's called Somewhere Down the Road. One, two, three. Get up, boys, it's 8:30. Don't know why we slept so late. Breakfast will just happen, wait for somewhere down the road. So grab the banjo and your guitar. We'll load them in our old blue car. I hope the next gig is not too far, somewhere down the road. Well, I'll take my turn behind the wheel for a couple hours until I feel I need a break. I then we'll be somewhere down the road. Yeah, tank of gas and we're on our way across the San Francisco Bay, past the town of San Jose, somewhere down the road. Oh, somewhere down the road, I know another town is waiting. We'll sing our songs of love and how she left him all alone. But when the show is over and the last few notes are fading, still thinking about my home somewhere down the road. Mm-hmm.
played here late last fall. Packed the place, had a ball out here on the road. We'll see our name on the marquee sign. The lights come up and we feel fine. Pretty girls clap their hands in time as we sing down the road. Boys in this town. Well, anytime you want to know where I'm headed, it's down the road. See that gal on the line, you find me there most any old time. For you hear the rooster crow, see me heading down the road. Well, now Farmer Jones, he owns a farm from the hog lot to the barn, from the barn and to the rail, made his living by carrying the mail.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. We'll be back in just a little bit.
Stretch your legs.
Busca llena de esperanzas el camino que los sueños prometieron a sus ansias. Sabe que la lucha es cruel y es mucha, pero lucha y se desangra por la fe que la empecina. Una va arrastrándose entre esquinas y en su afán de dar amor lucha y se destroza hasta entender que una se ha quedado sin corazón. Precio del castigo que una entrega por un beso que no llega o un amor que la engañó. Vacía ya de amar y de llorar, tanta traición. Si yo tuviera el corazón, el corazón que di, si yo pudiera como ayer amar sin presentir, es posible que a tus ojos que me gritan tu cariño los cerrara con mil besos y pensar que eran como esos otros ojos los perversos que me dieron mi vivir. Si yo tuviera el corazón, el mismo que perdí, se olvidará la que ayer lo destrozó y pudiera amarte, me abrazaría la ilusión para llorar tu amor. Pero Dios te puso en mi destino sin pensar que ya es muy tarde, no sabré cómo quererte. Déjame que llore como aquel que sufre en vida la tortura de llorar su propia muerte. Buena como eres, salvarías tu esperanza con mi amor. Una está tan sola en su dolor, una está tan ciega en su pena, pero un frío cruel que es peor que el odio, tumba horrenda de las almas, tumba horrenda de mi amor, maldijo para siempre y me robó la ilusión. No olvides, hermano, vos sabes, no hay que jugar por una cabeza. Me tejón de un día de aquella coqueta y risueña mujer que al jurar sonriendo el amor que está mintiendo, quema en una hoguera todo mi querer. Por una cabeza todas las locuras, su boca que ves. Thank you.
Got a bunch of moose up by our place.
Yeah. We see bears. Hey,
where do you keep those alligators?
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, bears. Yeah, there's bears all over the place. Our bears are, well, we got a lot of them. We have black bears and grizzly bears. Mountain lion. You guys have like pumas in the Everglades here, right? Is that right? Panthers, that's right. Florida panthers. Yeah, I think they're all the same. When, you know, they up around our country, they call them mountain lions, but they're all the same animal, really. They're big cats that'll eat you. All right, we're going to kick one off of an old Charlie Monroe song that Tom's going to sing for you.
Yeah, that's Jason. He lives here, folks. Keep your eye out for this dude.
All right. During the middle of the pandemic, well, was feeling sorry for myself. I've been playing cowboy songs and writing them and singing them for a long time, but I had never done a recording of them. So I thought, well, and now's a good time. So I did. I made a record of all Western and cowboy songs. About half of them are original, and there's a few old chestnuts that you'd probably recognize, and a few that some friends of mine wrote. But we're going to do you the title cut right now. And when I was writing this one, I thought I was done writing songs for this thing. I thought I had enough. And I was kind of, I felt like I was in kind of a rut of writing cowboy songs. And so I was intentionally trying not to write a cowboy song. So I had this melody rolling around in my head. And all of a sudden, out of the ether, lands the hook, and it's she's leaving Cheyenne. It's like, okay, well, I can still salvage this thing, and it won't be a cowboy song, even though it has the word Cheyenne in it.
Not too much longer,
here comes another line that dropped out of the ether and had the word cowboy in it. It's like, oh, jeez. All right, fine. It's a cowboy song. This is the last one, really. So here it is. It's my cowboy song that was not supposed to be written, but it ended up being the title cut to the to the record. So
to a cowboy record.
Which, by the way, actually ended up being the number one record in Wyoming for 2021. So I was very pleased with that. Thank you.
They really liked it in Cheyenne.
Yeah, they did. Here it is. It's called She's Leaving Cheyenne. There's a bitter wind blowing, coming out of the sage all around. She'd cry across the prairie. She'd take hold of my hand. It was just her and me, the way it would be if we were leaving Cheyenne. And there's nothing so sad as a heartbroken cowboy. I thought she would stay. There's nothing to say. She's leaving Cheyenne. Her voice had the shimmer of a high mountain stream, and her touch felt like feathers. At least that's how it seemed. She would smile when I'd tell her all about my big plans. How I knew that one day I'd draw home my pay. Cheyenne.
found me one evening, and to me she did say, I have come here to tell you I have found a new man. It's not much of a warning, the first light in the morning, I'll be leaving Cheyenne. And there's nothing so cold as a Wyoming winter, except for a girl who will betray a young man. And there's nothing so sad as a heartbroken cowboy. I thought she would stay, there's nothing to say, she's leaving Cheyenne. Oh, I thought she would stay, she's going away, she's leaving Cheyenne, she's leaving Cheyenne.
So much.
I bet if we do the old Scalpaho Road.
Okay. Okay. There is a road that runs from Phillipsburg, Montana to Hamilton, Montana. And it's mostly dirt. And it's only open about 3 months out of the year because of snow, and there's no guardrails. And the eastern side just kind of winds up through the timber, you know, jack pines and lodgepole pines, and it's very beautiful. And then you crest over the top, and the ecosystem changes immediately. It's amazing. All of a sudden, instead of jack pines and lodgepoles, you have this stuff they call bear grass, which is really wild stuff that has these big fluff balls but ponderosa pines. But the thing that after you notice that, you notice what you really notice is the fact that there's this incredible drop off to one side of the dirt road with as someone said, if you go off the edge, you'll fall for the rest of your life, which may not be very long.
Yeah, it's scary.
And and it's only about a lane and a half wide, so if you meet someone coming up the other side, they're coming up, it gets a little intense. But the name of the road is called the Scalpaho Road, and Scalpaho. So I wrote this song, it's kind of envisioning a freight wagon. I was thinking of like the, you know, 16 miles in the Erie Canal kind of thing, so I tried to make it kind of like an old folk song, and I'm not sure how successful I was, but at least I finished it. And it's not a cowboy song. Thank you. Yeah, it's an old, it's kind of a historical song, except for not really, because it never really was a freight road. But anyway, all that aside, here it is. It's called the Scalpaho Road.
Covered a day, four yoke of oxen and a heavy I can drive these mountains with the greatest of ease. Pulling the Hamilton as thick as you please. Coming down off the scalp of home road. Trail through Lowell is easy and wide, but it's a long way around once you're crossing it by. I can save 2 weeks, but it's a hell of a ride. Coming down Scalpel Road. Hey, homeboys, we're on our way. 18 miles yet to cover today. 4 yoke of oxen and a heavy load. Bound for the Scalpel Road, the Scalpel Road.
It's a tragic tale of the Old West.
Oh.
How about that?
John's been called a killer of nice people in his songs, and this song is, we'll just listen for it. Actually, many people die in this song.
Only 3.
Okay. Well, no record.
My record is 33. Yeah. I'm kind of proud of that.
We're not allowed to play that one in Florida, though.
Yeah.
Been banned.
Mm-hmm. This one, I wrote this one quite a while ago, and it sounded like an old-time melody to me. So, so I came up with the name of I thought, well, it should be about. Well, I'm not really sure what it should be about, but it sounded like it should be about a girl. And I came up with the name Sarah because it sounded like an old name. And then I needed a two-syllable last name. And so I went to the phone book. And
remember those?
I started looking through the phone book. And someone in Big Sky, Montana, by the last name of Hogan, has their name immortalized in this song. And I wasn't really sure what it was even going to be about, so I just started writing it. And if, as any songwriter, there might be some songwriters out here, but any songwriter will tell you that sometime the song will write itself, and you don't really know what's going to happen. And that's kind of what happened with this one. So, but I'm happy that only 3 people died. And. Sarah Hogan, as you might suspect.
Near the pine-covered hills of South Dakota, when the evening stars are shining cold and clear, and the drovers tell their stories round the campfire, a tale of Sarah Hogan you will hear. Sarah was the sweetest flower of the prairie, a flowing hair and blue eyes flecked with gray. Her smile could turn the sunshine into shadow, and the cowboys that came courting her would say, won't
Won't you meet me in the moonlight, Sarah Hogan? We can ride out in the hills, my Sarah dear. Hear that prairie wolf crying, he sings a mournful song, but I will not be lonesome. Billy Caldwell was a bold and reckless cowboy. He vied for Sarah's heart, and not in vain. But her father could not stand the charming rounder, and he forbade them both to ever meet again. Then Billy fell some bad men from Wyoming when they robbed the Tilford Bank. Two men were killed. There's the first two. Sarah did not know her lover was an outlaw. On the night she rode to see him in the hills, won't you make me in the moonlight, Sarah? Sarah dear, hear that prairie wolf crying, he sings a mournful song, I will not be lonesome with you here. In the quiet shadows, waiting for the outlaws, were some vigilantes shrouded by the night. Sarah's father raised a rifle to his shoulder as a mounted robber lined up in his sights. But when the sunshine tore the silence just like thunder, the bullet knocked the rider to the ground. When the man ran out to fetch the fallen outlaw, it was Sarah's lifeless body that they found. Won't you meet me in the moonlight, Sarah Hogan? We can ride out in the hills, my Sarah dear. Hear that prairie wolf crying, he sings a mournful song, but I will not be lonesome with you here. No, I'll be.
Thank you very much.
You gotta cheer these people up, John.
I know.
I'm about to cry.
We don't want that.
I knew she was gonna die too.
It happens every time.
Well, yeah.
Well, how about we leave you guys with the old Grandpa Jones song? How about that one? Who doesn't like an old Grandpa Jones song? Thank you to Chris for bringing us here to the Blue Bamboo.
Melody and Katie.
Yeah. Thank you.
And all of you.
Thank you to Jason for coming and sitting in with us. Yeah. Isn't he great? it's been like 10 years. We're trying to remember him when the last time we saw each other was.
I talked to him, and he's in a couple of bands around here.
He is.
And he should tell us where they are.
Yeah.
The names of the bands are so we can go see them.
Yeah, absolutely. He doesn't have a microphone, though, so we can't.
Yeah.
I'm sure he can find somewhere.
No, tell it. Jason, who do you play with? A guy named Billy. So look for a guy named Billy.
It'd be pretty simple.
Here we go.
Yeah.
We have a great band. It's called downtown. It's called Jason and Billy. We have a band called Southbound. We have a band at Epcot called Alberta Bound. And we play all over the place, Disney Springs, the Villages, a lot out at Disney. So.
Jason Thomas.
Yep, he is fantastic, as you know. Yeah. Check out his bands. He's originally from North Bay, Ontario, eh? You wouldn't know that, but he is. He's a Canadian.
Yeah.
And we played in North Bay. Jason and I played. We did a 10-day tour of Ontario and a little bit in Quebec. But we ended up, I think our last gig was in North Bay. Tom Murphy on the mandolin, everybody.
Thank you.
And the lovely and talented Joanne Gardner Lowell on the vocals.
And give it up for John Lowell on the guitar and vocals, songwriting.
Thanks. All right, we'll leave you with this one from my old Grandpa Jones. It's called 8 More Miles to Louisville. Thanks again, everybody.
Seeking fortune fair, up and down the Great Divide, I've traveled everywhere, from Portland east to Portland west and back along the line. I'm on my way to the place that's best, that old hometown of mine. 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles in this old road, I'll never be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. There's 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart. Well, there's bound to be a girl somewhere that you like best of all. Mine lives down in Louisville, she's long and she's tall. She's the kind that you can't find, rambling through the land. I'm on my way this very day to win her heart and hand. 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles in this old road, I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. There's 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart.
Yeah, Jason.
Well, now I can picture in my mind the place where we'll call home. From that little house for two, I'll never want to roam. Oh, the place that's right for that love sight is in them bluegrass hills, where gently flows the Ohio near a place called Louisville. 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles in this old road, I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. There's 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart.
to my view.
8 more miles in this old road, I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. There's 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart.
Yeah, there's 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
We'll see.
Sweet.
Aww. Thank you.
You want to hear one more song.
All right. All right, we'll do one more.
I know, silly question.
Okay. Does anybody get killed in this song?
No, but there's a lot of hard labor.
Okay, well, that's okay.
Speaking of hard labor, I just had a grandchild 2 days ago.
Did you have a tough time there, John?
A boy.
It was a boy, and it was really hard for me. I was... I don't know. I've never had a grandson before, so. And he's in England. He's going to be a British boy. So, one of you boys ought to kick a 9-pound hammer. How's that sound?
I think it's time for you to kick one.
How fast?
Half-assed?
Yeah.
There somewhere?
In this tunnel, that'll ring like mine, that'll ring. And when I'm long gone, you'd make my tombstone out of number 9 coal. Out of number 9 coal. So roll on, buddy.
Run,
don't
buddy,
you roll so slow.
Roll so slow.
How can I roll?
How can I roll
when the wheels won't go? So roll on, buddy.
Roll on, buddy.
Don't you roll so slow.
Roll so slow.
How can I roll when the wheels won't go?
Alrighty.
Thanks, everybody. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
We'll be in Gainesville tomorrow night at Heartwood Studios. So if you know anybody in Gainesville, have them come out. Heartwood Studios in Gainesville. So no, it's another show just like this one.
Not just like this.
But well, we won't have Jason with us, unfortunately.
Oh.
Unless he shows up and surprises us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody.
Thanks.